Welcome back friends, we will now study the subject manufacturing process in which we will see the part forming, in which we will see the topic forging hammers, presses and dies. Hammers operate by applying an impact loading on the workpiece. This is also called as drop hammer. Owing to the means of delivering impact energy, when the upper die strikes on the workpiece, the impact energy applied causes the part to take the form of the die cavity. Sometimes several blows of hammer are required to achieve the desired change in shape. Drop hammers are classified as gravity drop hammers, power drop hammers. In the figure we will see the head containing cylinder, piston rod, frame, ram and anvil. This is the figure of drop hammers. Gravity drop hammers, in which we will see, achieve their energy by the falling weight of the heavy ram. The force of the blow is dependent on the height of the drop and the weight of the ram. Power drop hammers, in this accelerate the ram by pressurized air or steam. Presses. In this, the force is given to the forging billet gradually and not like impact force. Mechanical presses. In these presses, the rotating motion of the drive motor is converted into the translation motion of the ram. They operate by means of eccentric cranks or knuckle joints. Mechanical presses typically achieve very high forces at the bottom of the forging stroke. Hydraulic presses. Hydraulically driven piston is used to actuate the ram. Screw presses. Apply force by a screw mechanism that drives the vertical ram. Both screw drive and hydraulic drive operate at relatively low ram speed. Forging dies. The figure shows the forging dies. In this figure, we will see inside draft angle, outside draft angle, corner, fillet, getter, rib, web, flash and land. There are two parts of the forging dies, upper die and lower die. In between there is a parting line. Now we will see parting line. The parting line divides the upper die from the lower die. In other words, it is the plane where the two die halves meet. The selection of parting line affects grain flow in the part, required load and flash formation. Draft. It is the amount of taper given to the sides of the part required to remove it from the die. Draft angles. It is meant for easy removal of part after operation is completed. 3 degree for aluminium and magnesium parts and 5 degree to 7 degree for steel parts. Webs and ribs. They are thin portions of the forging that is parallel and perpendicular to the parting line. More difficulty is witnessed in forming the part as they become thinner. Pellet and corner red eye. Small red eye limits the metal flow and increase stresses on die surfaces during forging. Flash. The pressure build up because of flash formation is controlled because flash formation is controlled. Proper design of wetter and flash land. Now we will see the part other forging operations. Offset forging. It is a deformation operation in which a cylindrical work piece is increased in diameter with reduction in length. In industry practice, it is done as closed die forging. Offset forging is widely used in the fastener industries to form heads on nails, bolts and similar products. The figure shows punch, stop, gripping die, feed, wire stroke. It is named as feeding the workpiece, then gripping the workpiece and retracting of stop. This is the second process. The third one is forward movement of punch and upsetting. Then fourth movement is or process is forging operation completes like this. Heading. The following figure shows variety of heading operations with different die profiles. Punch is given in the figure. There is die and workpiece is given. It is called as wire stock. The figure is named as heading a die using open die forging. Round head formed by punch only. Head formed inside the die only. And bolt head formed by both die and punch. Okay. Then long bar stock workpiece is fed into the machines by horizontal slides. The end of the stock is upset posed and the piece is cut to appropriate length to make the desired product. The maximum length at that can be upset in a single blow is 3 times the diameter of the initial wire stock. Swaging. Swaging is used to reduce the diameter of the tube or a rod at the end of the workpiece to create a tapered section. In general, this process is conducted by means of rotating dies that hammer a workpiece in radial direction inward to taper it as the piece is fed into the dies. A mandrel is required to control the shape and size of the internal diameter of tubular parts during swagging. Swagging is shown in the figure below. Starting diameter, work, feed, final diameter. The die is given, the side view of the die is given. The radial forging. This operation is same as swaging, except that the radial forging is the die do not rotate around the workpiece. Instead, the work is rotated as it feeds into the hammering dies. diameter reduction of solid work, tube tapering, swagging to form a groove on the tube. Swagging with different die profiles. Rolling forging. This rolling forging we will see in the next video lecture. Thank you for the session. Thanks.